Hi, welcome to Raw Math. Today we're going to talk about the coordinate plane. I'm going to talk about the coordinate plane relating it to a high school story. Because the coordinate plane is really the relationship of two variables, and the relationship between these two variables is very similar to the relationship between a high school drama story. We are going to start with this simple horizontal number line. Normally we call this number line the x-axis. The problem with calling it the x-axis is, what if we're not using the variables x and y? What if we're talking about the cost of taking a taxi ride? Our variables then will be x and or c and m, cost, c, m for number of miles you take the cab. So x and y are really limiting. So one way to get around this is to call this the horizontal axis. And when we call it the horizontal axis, that opens it up for any variable we want to use. So our x-axis, we're going to relate the x-axis to a male and the y-axis to a female. I know that's gender specific. You can do whatever genders you want. It could be male and male, female and female. I'm just doing he and she to simplify the story. It really doesn't have to be he and she. So we will call x-axis that cool cat in high school, like the captain of the football team. He's that guy that all the guys want to befriend, all the girls want to date. He's this really cool cat. He struts around his domain. He's a real independent soul. He has the input in whatever he does. People say, hey, where do you want to go after school? Well, one day he meets this really great girl, and she's beautiful, she's rich. She ends up being kind of like a trophy girlfriend. Generically, we call this the y-axis, but similarly to calling the x-axis x when we don't use x and y, we can rename our y-axis the vertical axis. So X and Y start to date. The thing is, while X struts around his domain, hanging out with all his friends, he may not always give Y the attention she craves. And she ends up being isolated away from her friends and family, so that Y is really her only connection to the outside world. So whereas X is strutting around his domain, Y is stuck at home with a range of emotions. When he's paying attention to her, she's happy. When he is ignoring her, she's sad. She has this range of emotions. X is this independent soul doing whatever he wants, while Y is completely dependent on X. Whereas X has the input of the relationship, Y is the output. These last two are pretty important terms in terms of math, input and output, because the output of a function is really what we focus on. If we were talking about the cost of taking that cab, when somebody takes a cab ride, you don't normally say, how many miles did you take the cab for? You say, how much did it cost? The output is really where we focus when we're talking about a math function. Okay, so these number lines cross at each of their 0 points. So we call the point of intersection 0, 0. This is the origin of the graph. Because these are each number lines and this point is the 0 point on the number line, on the x-axis, on our horizontal axis, coming out this way, we have our positive values, and going back, we have our negative values. Likewise, because of this being the 0 point in our vertical axis, as we go up from 0, we get positive, and as we go down from 0, we get negative. Each of the 4 sections that are broken up by the 2 number lines depict a specific quadrant. And when we talk about the quadrants, we call this one, this positive, positive one, the first quadrant, quadrant 1. This is quadrant 2. This down here is quadrant 3, and this over here is quadrant 4. You can remember that they go 1, 2, 3, 4, because it looks like a letter C. And as we all know, quadrant starts with the letter C. Okay, no, quadrant starts with the letter Q. The reason that the coordinates go 1, 2, 3, 4, it has to do with navigating. And when you navigate, the positive x-axis is considered 0 degrees for navigation. And as you are on the ocean and have 360 degrees of motion, the angle starts going up into the first quadrant, swings around to the second, down through the third, and finally through the fourth. And that's the real reasons our quadrants go 1, 2, 3, 4. Any point in this first quadrant, the x and the y values are both positive. Now I'm calling it x and y because when we do an ordered pair, x comes first, y comes second. You can think of that because x is the independent ruler of this relationship. You can think of it mathematically because it's alphabetical. The real reason is you start with your input and your input leads to your output. First quadrant, both positive. In the second quadrant, our input is negative, our output is positive. In our third quadrant, they're both negative. And our last quadrant, the input is positive and the output is negative. If we go back to that high school story, we could think of this as how the audience, if it were a movie, were rooting for them. The first situation is where both of them are happy. The second one is, despite X being in a bad mood, Y is still in a good mood. Here they're both having bad days. And then the last one, the situation that causes most of the turmoil in a movie and most of the drama we seek out, is X is having a great day while Y is not. I hope you've enjoyed this introduction to a coordinate plane. I hope you've learned a little bit of something new, and I hope to see you on the next video. Thank you.